later. Will you please report to my ready room?
Aye, sir.
Captain Picard is not satisfied with Kiman Drosin's assurances that the Ambassador is in good health. Do you consider Sarak capable of carrying out his mission?
Have I given you cause to think otherwise?
You have voiced certain reservations to me about his abilities.
I do not recall making such a statement.
Not directly, no. But you did question me about the diplomatic capabilities of both Captain Picard and Counselor Troy.
I am honor-bound to help Sarak carry out this mission. That is the only answer I can give.
Then you must decide which is your greater obligation. Your loyalty to Sarak, or your duty to the Federation. Can you accept the logic of continuing this mission?
Tell your captain. The mission is in jeopardy.
Sakoth has been able, until recently, to use his telepathic skills to reinforce Sarek's emotional control, thus protecting others from the effects of his deterioration.
He hasn't been doing a very good job.
The strain of this mission on Sarak has made it impossible.
It's ironic, isn't it? All this magnificent technology, we still find ourselves susceptible to the ravages of old age. Loss of dignity. A slow betrayal of our bodies by forces we cannot master. Do you still want to be one of us, Data?
Sir, it is conceivable, even for me, that time will eventually lead to irreparable circuit failure. But there is one thing I do not understand. Sarak is a logical, intelligent being. The effects of Bendai syndrome are apparent. Why would such a man choose to ignore them?
Logic fails us sometimes, Data. I think this is one of those times. I can only guess that he does not see, or he does not wish to see, the truth. And he is being insulated against that truth by those who love him most.
Someone has to confront him.
On a task that I'm looking forward to.
I don't understand this. Everyone is protecting Sarak, his wife, Mendrosen, even you.
What will you have me do? March down there and destroy the man?
The mission with the Lagarans cannot be carried out with Sarak in this condition.
I know that.
Then tell him that there is no way.
Don't you tell me what to do!
Captain, Commander.
Of course. You're right, number one. It's a task that I will attend to.
Captain, I don't think I understand what you're telling me. My husband is responsible for your crew assaulting one another.
He is very ill, Perrin.
Bendai syndrome is more a folktale than a disease. There hasn't been a true case of it in my husband's lifetime.
There's one now. Sakoth knows.
Sakoth? Sakoth knows nothing. My husband didn't teach him.
He knows. And more than that, on this mission, he has been consciously holding Sarek's mind together as well as he could.
That is not true.
I must see Sarek.
Captain, I know a good deal about the Vulcan mind. And I know a good deal about the heart of one particular Vulcan. I am his wife, and he is fine. He does not have Bendai syndrome, and that shall be the end of it.
I'm sorry.
Please. You must not do this to him.
Must not do what, my wife? If Captain Picard wishes to see me, he may do so.
Lots of beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, so beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, lots of beans. beans, yeah.
I love beans, diggity doo.